Hello everybody, in this Rhino video demo, I would like to talk about the basics of SubD modeling. Okay, let's start. Essentially, there are multiple ways that we can create SubD objects using Rhino. The more common methods include creating from SubD primitives, from NURBS curves, and from mesh objects. Let's start by talking about creating from SubD primitives. Going to open up the SubD tools toolbar and use the SubD box for our first demo and click on it, and you can see that there are some options that we can play with. The important ones are X count, Y count, and the Z count. Okay, these are basically the number of segments along the X, Y, and Z axis correspondingly. So let's say if I want to change the number of segments on the y-axis, I can click on this and change it. Okay, let's say just to hit enter, and then you can proceed to create the SubD object on screen. But yeah, so we got something like that. And to toggle between the smooth and the flat mode, you can press the tab key. I'm pressing the tab key now, and if I press it again, I can toggle it back to the smooth mode. Okay, so this is the first method. Okay, another method that we can create SubD object is through NURBS curves. Okay, I'm going to do a simple demo now. I'm going to use the control point curve. Let me make a few copies. So I got some curves, and I can create a surface from it using, for example, in this case here, the SubD loft. You know, the SubD loft. 1, 2, 3, 4, enter. And we can create SubD object from here. Let's turn on the corner. This will ensure the corner is sharp. Okay. I'm not going to dwell too much on it, as going to be only a basic demo. Click the cancel. Okay. Now I want to talk about the third method, which is using a mesh object. And let's go to the mesh tools. And I'm going to use the mesh box for our demo. Okay, you can click on the mesh box. Again, you'll be prompted with things like the X count, Y count, and the Z count, which is similar to what was prompted when you use the SubD box. Okay, so let's say I change this to 2, enter. We got a mesh box. Okay, to convert this into a SubD object, you can type 2 SubD. Press enter and then click on whatever options you need. Okay, let's say I want to delete the input. Press enter, and now your mesh object has been converted to SubD. Okay, and again, if you press the tab key, you can toggle between the flat and the smooth mode. Okay. Okay, with SubD, basically the editing of the form is done through the modification and manipulations of the sub object elements, namely the vertex, the edge, and the face. And to be able to select the vertex, the edge, or the face, we can either use the shift plus control keys, pressing and holding the shift plus control keys, and then select the relevant sub object. Okay, for example, I selected the face here. Okay, and let's say if I want to select this, I can press the shift plus control. You can see that I'm able to select the vertex. Okay, and then shift control, I can select the edge. Okay, Another method that you can select these subjects is to use the selection filter by clicking on this and then click on the subject, okay? And then you can select the face, the vertex, and the edge, okay? And once you're done with whatever work that you need to do, for example, now I want to extrude and I decided that I would like to select the whole object again, I can disable the subject, and now you notice that I'll be able to select the entire object again. Okay. One last thing I would like to talk about in this demo is the basics of symmetry modeling within SubD. And it's actually pretty easy, and I want to use the SubD box for a demo. Okay, I want to do a symmetry modeling, let's say of an object reflected about this axis here. Okay, I'm going to click on this and maybe I'll just set my point count to all one. Okay, and you can simply model on one half. Okay, maybe something like that. Let's turn on the subject and select this and press delete. Okay, so if I want to exercise symmetry modeling over here, I can use the reflect subd object tool over here. Okay, so let me just toggle back to the object selection instead of the subject, okay? And then let's click on this reflect subd object, and then you ask for the subd object to reflect, is this, enter. Let me repeat this again, okay? So it asks you for the reflection plane. Okay, so I'm going to select 2 points to define the reflection plane. First point, second point, okay, and then the side. Okay, you can click the flip to flip the side that is the primary side of reflection. It's going to be this, so I press enter, and you can see that, yep, we have the reflected object over here. And if I have to make any modification on the main side, for example, I want to extrude another segment, you can see that the change will be reflected on the other half as well. With that, I come to the end of this demo. Hope that's been useful. See you. Bye.